Welcome to So Like a Pro Time. I'm Teresa Sigmund, and you are in the right place to learn to choose, alter, and make the Dancesport, country, and skate dress of your dreams. Now, in today's video, I'm sitting in front of my laptop because I want to share with you details about a dress redesign I discussed with one of my So Like a Pro members during our live Q&A call that happened just a few minutes ago. So let's go ahead and just jump right in. I want to talk about what works and what doesn't work. So I'm going to share my screen with you, and here is the dress in question. This is one of the So Like a Pro members, and she purchased this dress a while back for a really good price. And this is what it looks like on the dress form, and this particular woman is wider than the dress was originally made for. Let's talk about what I wanted to change on this dress for her. If this is the original dress, and this is the way it stretches out on her, on this original, it has quite a lot of diagonal lines going on created with the steep diagonal on the back V, and hopefully you're watching my mouse. And there's also the diagonal drapes that go on here. And then the skirt is a slight diagonal. This is my least favorite aspect of this particular design. And I have no idea who made this dress. The student bought this at a very bargain price, and so that's all I know. Now, when she's in it, all of these lines become very horizontal. So the first thing I said to this particular woman is, I said, is this a necklace? I said, you have too many horizontal lines going on. We've got one at the neck, one across the center of the back, the drape, we've got where it attaches to the bodice, and we've got the one along the skirt. There are five horizontal lines here. And this is not good for a wider, curvy woman because it just makes her look wider as opposed to taller. And you can see from the height of her dance partner, who is her husband, that there's a significant height difference. So we want her to look taller and thinner if at all possible. So move this down here. Now, so this up at the top is a necklace. She says, yes, it's a necklace. I said, good, get rid of it. Because from the back, it does you no favors. And if you're doing standard in this, you don't need the bling in the front. Who cares? Second question I asked her was, do you physically need this elastic strap across the back? If not, get rid of it. And she says, no, I'm pretty sure it'll stay on my shoulders just fine. I said, good, get rid of it. So I photoshopped it out of the picture. Now look at the difference just getting rid of these two horizontal lines. She already looks taller and therefore slimmer because we've created a better space. The other thing I want to get rid of and return it back more to the original shape of the dress is to get rid of this horizontal drape that happened when she stretched the fabric out so much. What used to be a sloping curve has become straight across. So I suggested that she remove the stitching from the left side of the dress and reattach this drape somewhere so that it creates a nice diagonal line, which will once again create height and the illusion of more, and she'll be more slim looking. Now that may attach completely at the back of the V. She'll have to play around with that on herself to see how that works. If she feels too revealed right here in this fleshy area in the low of her back, I said just add some flesh mesh if you want to cover it up. And that way you don't feel quite so exposed, but yet we're creating the line with the white fabric, a nice diagonal line. Last thing we talked about is, and these are all pretty simple alterations for those of you who know how to sew, is there are gathers. There's just sort of a gather pleated area that runs diagonally on the front. And for who knows what reason, this designer thought it was a great idea to end it at the side seams. Now, I hate that on dance dresses or skate dresses and street clothes. It drives me up the wall. Why not continue the design all the way around the dress, right? So I suggested that she take this, where this gathering ends on the side seam, and continue it so that it goes diagonally up and blends in with this white. Now I did all this in yellow so that she could see it really clearly. You would of course use fabric to match your dress, not yellow. And that way we create a really nice vertical line. this little short one right here, I said, just go ahead and just continue it on into the skirt and then create a second vertical line going up. So look at the difference from here to here. It's tremendous. And then this line right here sort of estimates where this drape will go. So this entire back will then open up and create a completely different look on the dress. Now, we also talked about, what do we mess with this on the hip or mess with the skirt attachment down here? And the answer is no. She bought a bargain dress to save money, but if you end up putting dozens and dozens of hours into a bargain dress, it's no longer a bargain. So I suggested that she not mess with this skirt at all. It's still not a flattering line, but by the time we've changed the back shape and created two new diagonal lines to draw the viewer's eye away from her tush, then we've created a lot of positive changes. So that is it. I just wanted to share those tips with you. And if you have enjoyed them, please share this video with all your dancing, skating, sewing friends. Don't forget to go to sewlikeapro.com. Leave me your name and email address so you never miss one of these sewing tips. And lastly, please leave me a comment. What do you like about this dress? What do you like about the changes? And what would you do if it was your dress? Thanks so much, and I will talk to you again another time.